3 days after being taken into custody by the military junta, the Malian transitional president and prime minister are still being held at this military base outside Bamako. They've now resigned, according to the junta, and will eventually be released.
Je peux vous confirmer que le président de la transition, M. Bandao, et le premier ministre Mokhtar Wan, donc ont démissionné. Donc les personnes détenues vont recouvrir leur liberté, mais cela se fera de façon graduelle pour des raisons de sécurité, des raisons évidentes de sécurité.
The man behind the arrest on Monday is Colonel Assimi Goïta, the transitional vice president who also orchestrated Mali's coup last year. He recited a list of accusations against the president and the prime minister. The latter had allegedly violated the transitional charter by forming a new government without consulting him, a cabinet that didn't include two major former junta leaders. Mediators from the West African bloc ECOWAS, alongside a UN peacekeeping mission, are continuing negotiations with the military amid what the international community is calling a second coup in 9 months.
What I can say is that there's cordial discussion going on, friendly discussion going on, for the common interests of the people of Mali.
The United States and France have threatened to impose targeted sanctions should the civilian interim leaders not be released. The UN Security Council joined the calls for their unconditional release, but stopped short of calling the arrests a coup or announcing punitive measures.